You woke up on Wednesday, November 20th, excited to play the new ranked season of Teamfight Tactics. Set 2 is out, you're checking out streams. What are these popular streamers playing? Oh, this guy's playing Ocean Mage, he's getting first. Wait a minute, this other guy's also playing Ocean Mage. Great, I know what build I'm gonna take to ranked. And then I know what happened. You tried out this build, and then you noticed something. This other guy is playing Ocean Mages. Wait a minute, also this guy's playing Ocean Mages, and before you know it, you have four or five other people in the lobby all going for the same build. None of you can upgrade the brand, maybe one of you gets lucky. None of you can find the Annie because it's everyone is contesting it. You end up getting sixth, seventh at best. Well, today I'm gonna be bringing you a different build that is not Ocean Mages that can consistently get you top four. That will be the Blade Master Assassins. My name is Jinx JK, and I'm gonna take you step by step with the leveling guide, as well as the early, mid, and late game transitions of how to put this build together. Let's get to it. Before we look at the Blade Master Assassin build, I quickly just want to answer a question that I see in every chat of streamers that I check out. What's better, 6 Mage or the 3 Mage 3 Summoner version? The Summoner variation is by far the better one. You're adding in Yorick at level 8. And by the way, your power spike is Inferno at level 7. Do not, I don't want to see you doing this. Oh, Yorick is a 4-cost unit. It must be better. No, you want the Inferno. Even if it has to be with the Varus, with the Kindred, whatever it is, that's your power spike. As Brand, all of his bounces will be leaving that little Inferno dot behind. So, yes, that's your level 7 power spike. And then at 8, you're adding in Summoners. If you do get the Mage cap, do not get baited into going 6 Mages. Just throw that on the Annie. Double Tibbers is good enough, or you can throw it on the Nami if you're getting the Nami a little bit earlier, which you will be replacing the Thresh for. All right, let's quickly look at a leveling and econ guide for set 2. Now, this is a general guide. This will not be the case for every single game. You might have to make adjustments. Maybe you're not hitting the units that you need and you're gonna have to be spending all your gold. But for starters, if you're a beginner, follow this guide for now, and as you get more comfortable, you can start deviating away from this. So, what you want to do is the very first PvP round, you want 10 gold. Then, on the next round, you're going to be leveling up to 4 while staying at 10 gold. The round after that, you're going to be going to 20 gold by selling the Carousel unit. I posted how to do that on my Hyperoil Predator build. Then after that, you're gonna be pushing level 5, still staying at 20 gold. The round after that, you're hitting 30 gold. And from this point, you're just econing. You should be at 50 gold by 3-1. Now, on 3-2, this is where you level to 6, and you wanna roll down to about 30 gold, okay? This is the same. Maybe you're not hitting anything, you might need to go a bit lower, but generally speaking, 30 gold. Now you wait one more round. If you hit absolutely nothing this round, you roll back down to 30 gold. Again, this might not always be the case. After that, you should be able to econ all the way to wolves. You don't usually want to be spending on these rounds. It's very rare occasions that you're spending on these 2 rounds. And finally, you're going to be pushing to level 7. Now, this is when you want to roll down almost all your gold to finish your build, basically, right? The point and a good indicator for you to not spend is if the unit you're rolling for is super contested and it's not going to do you any good to just spend the rest of your gold for a contested unit. Or the other scenario is where you have just one upgrade left, right? It's just one unit that you haven't two-starred. It's not worth rolling for at that point. Your build is strong enough and you can start ecoing back up to hopefully get level 8 by beginning of round 5. All right, let's get to the good stuff. And first, we're going to talk about item priority. So first, you want to prioritize the Nocturne. with the main item being Rage Blade. This is the first item you want to get on him. And then you're looking for a damage item like Infinity Edge. He does not need Lifesteal because the more damage his third auto does, the more he heals for. So if he's critting on that third auto, you'll just see his health going back to full every time. Now for the third item, you want a defensive item. That being Dragon's Claw as the best option. If you can get that second Negatron Cloak, then Swordbreaker works really well on him. And then something else that you want to look to do is, instead of a defensive item, you can look to make him a Blade Master, because at level 8 we're adding in a Mystic, and that Mystic will be Master Yi. So this is not required for Blade Master, it's just a really, it just makes the build even stronger than it already was without for Blade Master. This is still really, really good. As we said, get that defensive item next. You want to look to itemize either the Sivir or the Kha'Zix, depending on the lobby. If you see it's just a lobby full of mages, go ahead and look for the Hush and Red Buff. Of course, the Hush first. Red Buff is more for, you know, the players stacking Warmogs, Thornmail, and Olaf, or light players. You're gonna need the anti-heal, and Sivir is your best way to spread it around to the majority of the units. And finally, we have the Seraph's Embrace on the Kha'Zix. Really, really good item. After that, a really good combination can be the Gunblade. If not the Gunblade, you're looking for, again, Infinity Edge. Otherwise, you're just looking for a defensive item, again, like Dragon Claw. Okay, now a quick note about Yasuo over here is, on a Cloud map, you're going to be getting Cloud really early with the Qiyana. You won't be needing the Janna to get the Cloud buff. And so Iceborne Gauntlet, even though it's nerfed, becomes really, really good on a Cloud map. As we said, you are getting it super early with the Qiyana buff. All right, before we take a look at the transitions between early, mid, and late game, I just want to quickly touch on your win condition, and that's going to be Nocturne 3. That's the unit you're going to be trying to 3-star, okay, over anything else. Another good unit to 3-star in this comp particular will be the Yasuo. So those are the two that you're looking for, but the priority is the Nocturne 3. It will allow you to secure first place. So the reason I'm bringing this is because sometimes it might be a better choice to not go level 8 and rather spend that gold to try and 3-star the Nocturne, as your odds of hitting a 3-cost unit do go lower at level 8. So that's a choice you're going to have to make from game to game. Am I leveling to 8? Do I need that Mystic buff? Or am I close to getting a Nocturne 3? Maybe I'm going to stay at level 7 and spend some gold to try and 3-star him if no one else in the lobby is contesting this unit. Now don't worry if you're not always getting first place with this build. You just want to consistently top 4. There's going to be players who high roll the Ocean Mage comp. There's going to be someone who gets a Brand at level 5. There's nothing you can do about that, right? There's going to be games where you're the lucky one. You're finding the early Kha'Zix. You're getting the insane item early combination with Rage Blade and Infinity Edge. For now, focus on consistency. Let's look at some units that will help get you through the early game. Now, the best by far is Woodland Druid. You're looking to grab Maokai, Ivern, and either LeBlanc or Nico. Now, the LeBlanc is preferred as it can be one of the assassins you're using to get an early assassin buff in. Next up, we have the Predators, and that being Warwick, Kog'Maw, and Rek'Sai. Now, Rek'Sai is in the final build, so this is great as you can then just sell the Warwick and Kog'Maw once you have the better units to replace them, like the Yasuo, the Sivir. And now I just want to quickly look at some really good one cost units that you can use once upgraded. You know, Gnossus, Renekton, and Zyra, just really strong units right now. Do try and prioritize them over the other one cost units. And again, Renekton can be used as an early desert with a Sivir until you find the Kha'Zix. And we're gonna take one of these as an example. We're gonna be using the Woodlands to talk about the transition. So you got your early Woodlands, and then you're looking to add in the units as you're getting them, right? So Renekton will most likely be first. Really good, strong, one cost. then you're looking to add in the Yasuo, and your big power spike comes in when you can get that Sivirin for both Desert and Blade Master buff. Now, let's say you're using the LeBlanc instead. This is a scenario where if you're not getting the Sivir, you're not getting the Yasuo, you can get the Assassins in first. Go ahead, use the Diana and either the Qiyana or Nocturne, whichever one you found first, again with our Woodlands, and we have our Desert ready to go once we get the Sivir. Now, a question I get asked often is, when do I replace my Woodlands? They can usually last you all the way up until Wolves, or until you upgrade your, you know, Yasuo Nocturne. That's when these units can come out, an upgraded Yasuo and Sivir, and you can take these out for the Desert Blade Master buff. So we're gonna be going ahead and doing that, you know, once our Nocturne is upgraded, we're gonna be taking out the Diana, in goes the Nocturne. We still have our Assassin buff. You've upgraded your Yasuo and Sivir. We can take out the Woodlands. Here we go, we still have our three Assassins, and all you're doing now is looking to push for that level 7 to get in our Kha'Zix and our Janna. There we go. And of course, once you have the Rek'Sai, that can replace the Renekton, and there is our build complete. Now, I want to show you a variation in which case you're not getting the Blade Master. Now, this is still really, really strong, but the units are a little bit more contested. That being said, sometimes you just happen to find them, and this will be the Summoner variation. So rather than our Blade Masters with the Cloud combination, we're going to be going for the Azir, Annie, and Yorick. And the contested units, as I said, will be this Annie and Yorick. If you do happen to find them though, this is how you can utilize them. Very, very strong again. And the only thing about this is you can't add Mystic until level 9. You're looking to finish, the build is finished at level 7, and then 8 and 9, you're adding in two Mystics, Janna, Master Yi. All right, that brings us to the end of the video. Go ahead now, get some ranked games in, enjoy the grind. Let me know in the comments below how it goes. Until then, I stream 5 days a week over at twitch.tv/jinxjk. I'll see you there.